Hey there, I'm Anand Chaudhary, an 8th grader from John F. Kennedy Middle School, and recently we've been talking about derivatives and limits. In this video, I'm going to go over some things that are really useful in order to find derivatives, the product rule and the quotient rule. They're two very fundamental things to know when you're taking derivatives, because you're going to use them quite a lot when you're multiplying things and dividing things. So why don't we head on into it? Starting off with the product rule. The product rule, as you can just think about, has something to do with multiplying. So let's go over here with like an idea of fx is equal to 5x times 20x squared. And let's say we want to find the derivative of it. So now, before you guys know the product rule, you guys are just going to think you're going to take derivative of 5x, take derivative of 20x squared, separately multiply them together, but that's not how you do it. That'll get you an incorrect answer. So the way you're actually going to do it, it's actually fairly simple. So what you're going to do is you're going to, let's start off by taking 5x, okay? We're going to take that value, keep it the same. We're going to keep that the same, and we're going to take the derivative of this one using the power rule. So in order to, when you find the derivative of this, it's going to equal to 40x, okay? Very simply. So basically, I'm going to write, by definition, what it's equal to in just a second. But we're going to find this, and then you're going to add it to the complete opposite this time. This time you're going to find the derivative of this and leave this the same. So it's going to be derivative of 5x is 5 times 20x squared. Okay? Very simple how you find this. If you want, you can simplify this, but I'm just going to leave it at that, trying to give you guys a general idea of what this is. So let's say if we're given fx, I'm writing the definition here, and we have fx of a squared times b squared. What you're going to do, sorry for the noises in the background, it's just my dog getting a little anxious with people walking around. Fx is equal to a squared times b squared, so what you're going to do, by definition, in order to find this, f inverse of x is equal to, let's see here, it's going to equal to a squared. Okay, you know what? Let's leave it without the squared for now, okay? Because we're writing by definition. Because these both could be any value. So it's going to be a times derivative ddx of b plus ddx of a times b. Simply said, by definition, this is the product rule. Very simply, okay? Next, we're gonna go on to the quotient rule. I'm gonna have a little border here. The quotient rule. Again, a very simple rule, except this time I kind of have a little saying for the definition-wise. So let's say we're given fx is equal to x squared by 5x. And we want to find the derivative. Now, before knowing any of these rules, you guys would just think the same thing here. Take derivative of this, divide them, you're done. Completely wrong, okay? In this one, you're gonna write, you know, I think if I write the definition on this one first, it'll make more sense because I've already written the definition of this. So the definition of this would equal to f of x, again, equal to a by b. But the way I'm going to say it is a much different way than I'm going to write it. So it's going to be f inverse of x is equal to low d high, meaning the low times derivative of high. So that would be b times d dx of a, low d high, minus high d low. Again, same thing except you're taking derivative of the bottom. So it's kind of the same fundamental here, except we have to find what the denominator is to, minus high d low. So it's going to be a, and remember, you can't switch up this order because it's specific with the subtraction. So minus high times d dx, high d low, and then you square the bottom. So basically it would be b squared, and away you go. So that's basically the definition of quotient rule. Okay, that's my fun little way of saying it. Lodi high, Montagny low, square the bottom, and away we go. So, very simple saying I have for quotient rule. So now if we were to solve this, using our quotient rule here, f inverse of x is going to be Lodi high, so it's going to be 5x times derivative of that times 2x minus high u low minus high u low. So that's going to be x squared times 5. Square the bottom and away we go, so it'll be 25x squared. You guys will have the ability to further simplify that, but I will leave it at that for now. So these are the product rule and quotient rule in a nutshell, and thank you for watching. Please subscribe my video, please leave feedback in the comments, and thank you for watching.